Seth's sitting in for Bill tonight, and unfortunately, he does not appear to be ready to deliver any good weather news for us.
Not what we want.
Well, it depends on how you look at it. Some people really love the cold, some people don't. I mean,
Nobody likes cold. More people don't. That's a fact.
I love it. I'll take it. I guess coming from Louisiana where it's hot all year round, yeah, cold's okay for me. But no, I mean, when you compare today to yesterday, that's when it's a problem, because all you wanted to do yesterday was spin it outside. It was sunny, it was warm.
As long as you didn't blow away.
Yeah, and then today it was just cold and downright miserable. So that's kind of how we're going to go straight forward. But hey, we broke a record over the weekend. If you hadn't been paying attention, our wettest year on record has already come to pass. 67.02 to date. But guess what? We still have 29 days left to record. So we're going to keep pushing that number up. But the reason being that we pushed it so quickly over the last few months is because we had the wettest fall of all time on record as well. September, the wettest September ever, the third wettest October, and then even November came in a little bit above average. But it just goes to show that even the driest season on record was still the wettest because of all that rain and that we've had the last few months. Fall 2018 came in as the seventh wettest season ever recorded. So pretty impressive stuff in the last 3 months. And then we still have the rest of December to get through, and we're already recording more rain. Today we had just a few little light showers come through, mostly as rain or drizzle, but we've also seen a little mix over in a few spots, like right now going through a little bit of Powell into Menifee County. Light showers mostly is a mix at this point, some sleet, maybe a few flakes, especially down in the southeastern counties on top of the ridges. That's really about it. Nothing that's going to really cause a problem throughout the overnight period. It's basically just a dying cold front bringing in that cold air. What's going to happen tomorrow night, though, a little bit of an uptick in moisture, and temperatures will be below freezing, so that will give a chance for some decent snow going into Wednesday morning, and then eventually all that clears out as that little bit of high pressure builds in. And that, of course, is before the next system that comes through Thursday night into Friday. So pretty active week coming up, but when you think about it, this is really not a lot going on. We're not talking about a bunch of fronts that come through and really pack in the moisture. It's just here and there a few showers every once in a while that's going to go through tonight, tomorrow, and then eventually into Wednesday as well. Starting off as snow tomorrow morning because temperatures will be below freezing. We may see a little bit of a mix back to rain as we get above freezing, but then it's not long before it crashes right back down and then more snow in the mix. The best chance for snow is late Tuesday into Wednesday morning. Could put down about an inch in some spots, and I think that's the most we see. Really, it's going to be just a few tenths of an inch, but everybody pretty much in our forecast region has up to an inch potential all the way through Wednesday morning, and it's going to be slippery commutes, whether it be Tuesday night, Wednesday morning, or even in the afternoon as well. So just keep that in mind. The next few days are going to be really cold, but we also have a chance to collect a little bit of snow. Now on Thursday, we do go up in temperature. That's basically just because we get a little uptick, some warm air, winds out of the south. That's going to push us to about 42 for the afternoon high. And when the moisture gets here, when the precipitation falls, I think it's all going to be rain. So by Thursday, anything that falls and collects will have melted. But we do not get warmer than our normal high any time this week. Look at that, 67 yesterday. We dropped 21 for today, and then we're just going to kind of ride right along our normal highs, but well below all the way through the upcoming weekend. So if you didn't take advantage of yesterday, it's going to be a little while before we get weather again like that. Overnight tonight, temperatures down near freezing, just a little bit below. And yeah, there could be a few mixed showers around, but tomorrow it's going to start as snow, turn to mix, and then go right back to snow as the temperatures just get a little bit above freezing. So a very cold day on tap expected for both Tuesday, Wednesday, warm it up a little bit on Wednesday or on Thursday, but not much. In Friday, it's a dry day, but that's not going to be lasting very long. As we get into the weekend, a bigger system comes through, and now we have an even better chance for both rain and snow. So, winter here to stick around.